My name's Aida Nambeya Mukuka, and I'm the representative of Stephen Lewis Foundation. And my role is to go to the countries that the Stephen Lewis Foundation supports and be able to assess the projects and see if we can partner with them or whether the Stephen Lewis Foundation can support them. And what I can say is that there's been a lot of success in terms of turning the tide. And one specific example that I can give is one of the projects that I visited recently, where a girl who is an orphan was being supported by a project that the Stephen Lewis Foundation supports. And after this girl was supported through finishing her high school, the girl is now teaching at a community school where there are no teachers, and she's teaching little children there. And for me, that is really turning a tide, because she's been able to contribute to our own community through the support from the foundation. She's been able to be empowered with education, and she's able to give back to our community. And not only that, the girl is still continuing with her studies. I'm sure she said she would be able to do that for like 3 years, and then she would be taking up another course, and of course also being supported by the foundation. But that was really a good example that I was thinking I can share with you. Well, the role of the grandmother in Africa, I think we all know the grandmothers are the backbone of the communities in Africa. And it's been very important for me to see the foundation support the grandmothers. Some of the grandmothers are so old such that they cannot be able to manage to actually work again. But through the support of the projects that support the grandmothers are able to have the food, and they are also able to send their children to school so that at least they can get to be in school. So it's been very important in terms of supporting the grandmothers in Africa. The conference in Swaziland was very important, and I had a chance to actually interact both with the Canadian grandmothers and the African grandmothers. And actually, one of the things that I learned from the African grandmothers after they came together at the gathering, they said that, you know, when they're in their countries, different countries, they always think this problem only affects them. But coming to share with other grandmothers, they really felt that this problem was not the problem for only them, but that it was a problem for the whole Africa. And coming to the relationship with the grandmothers, it's been a very good relationship, because the grandmothers in Canada have been very strong in mobilizing resources, while the grandmothers in Africa are there doing the work, but they lack resources. There are a lot of challenges that they face, and their relationship has been very good. And even in Swaziland, they really interacted a lot, they supported each other. So it's really been a very good relationship. I think the uniqueness of the support that the Stephen Lewis Foundation gives, one, I think the foundation is very much part of what is going on in Africa. It's very different with other donors. I mean, I've been to projects where I see that some certain donors just send support to projects and they don't go. But the foundation sends a representative, not only once, but we keep going to give support. Our going to the projects is not about inspecting what they are doing or following up, what they're using, what are they doing with the money. No, our support or the relationship that the foundation wants is to be part of what's going on, to be able to be part of the successes that are going on, even to be part of the challenges. Because our job, especially us as representatives, when we go there, we don't really talk about the money came, what have we done with it and all that. We kind of like follow steps, how is that money helping the people, and how are the people accessing the support that's coming, even the organization. So sometimes there are some challenges that we find and discuss them together in the way forward, and sometimes we are there to just witness what's going on. And that kind of operation with the Stephen Lewis Foundation has been very unique, because there are certain projects where we've gone more than even 6 times, but we all want to strengthen our relationship and make sure that the support that the foundation gives to the projects goes to the right people that need it. So it's been a very unique relationship that we've been involved in. We like part of them and they're like part of the Stephen Lewis Foundation, even if the foundation is in Canada. But looking at the support that we give to the people on the continent, it feels like even in this, the foundation is in Africa, not really like there's that gap. There's no gap. We've been very close with the project, and that's really well appreciated. And that's the uniqueness with the foundation's support to the projects. In the work that I'm doing, there are challenges and there are also successes as we do the work. And one of the things that gives me a lot of hope is, I think, to find people doing good work, like where you find that a project is supporting children to be in school. And you really go and you find the children in school. You talk to the teachers. They tell you these children are supported by this project and the children are doing well in school. So that way you really feel hopeful that the work is being done, because that's what we want. We want to see that the children are going to school. We want to see that the grandmothers are happy. You visit the grandmothers, they will tell you on a monthly basis, I get the support from this organization. Maybe this person lost, like, I visited a grandmother who lost like 10 children to AIDS and had these grandchildren, and the grandchildren were put in school by the project I was visiting, and the grandmother was also accessing some food. So you get really hopeful when you get such stories. You celebrate with them that at least this is hopeful. And there are some times that, you know, you really find a bit of challenges with the project. The way that you expect them to do things is not the way. But that's really, we try to discuss about the issues that come out, and we try to support them, and that's where our support comes in. So meanwhile, that could be a little bit of a stress, because maybe you don't expect them to do what they have done, but at the end of the day, it is also helpful and hopeful, because that's the reason I'm sent there. I'm sent to the project to go through the challenges and discuss the challenges, and yes, the challenges are major challenges which conflict with our values. But if there are challenges that we really need to talk about, we really need to talk about, it's the reason I have to travel from Zambia to Kenya, from Zambia to Uganda, from Zambia to Ethiopia. It is to celebrate the success. It is to talk about the challenges, and if they are fixable, we have to fix them. And that's why we keep going. If they send me back next time to the same project, I have to monitor what I said last time. Have they done it? And it's been very hopeful, because some of the projects, after you talk about the challenges and you go back, you find that they fixed it. Even if it's not completely fixed, but they fixed some. And so you feel good. You celebrate your success, and even it gives you a lot of strength and motivation to move forward, that okay, so when you talk about something, maybe those people were not just aware about this and they've been aware. So the challenges remain. The success and being hopeful and motivated about my work is also a greater thing that I've actually found in the work that I'm doing. I know the foundation has been doing a lot of support to a lot of projects in Africa, but I think it's also good to say that, you know, the issues are still there. There's still a lot that needs to be done. And really the foundation has a lot of work ahead of them to do, because the issues are a lot. And as we travel, we see different issues coming up. And even the same issues, it's not like AIDS is gone now. AIDS is still there and people are still dying. So there is still need. The foundation has a lot of work. As I can state it, they still need a lot of resources to be able to support a lot of grassroots projects out there in Africa. Yeah.